For president also keeps ramping up. Former President Trump took to X while Democratic vice presidential nominee Tim Walz flies solo. NBC's Chris Pallone has the latest.
In a two-hour freewheeling conversation with billionaire supporter Elon Musk Monday, former President Donald Trump talked about AI, electric cars, his relationship with world dictators, and the stakes of the election, hitting Vice President Kamala Harris on substance and style.
I saw a picture of her on Time magazine today. She looks like the most beautiful actress ever to live. It was a drawing.
Trump has not held a campaign rally since Friday and won't be back on the trail until Saturday. As Vice President Harris climbs in the polls, Trump's allies, in public and private, are urging him to be more disciplined with his attacks.
The path forward is to focus on policy. Those are three words for the Republican Party that I think is a path to success. Focus on policy.
Trump has been critical of the White House's handling of the economy.
We want companies to build here, not to build in other locations, and we want to create jobs. Again, it's about the American dream. You don't hear about the American dream anymore.
But a new poll shows for the first time this cycle, voters think the economy will do better under the Democrat. Today, an inflation indicator came in better than economists expected.
Nothing has actually changed objectively in terms of the economic numbers or people's personal finances in the last 3 weeks. What has changed is the mood.
Democrats trying to keep the mood trending upward heading into their convention next week, with Governor Tim Walz in California today headlining his first campaign event since being added to the ticket.
In response to Donald Trump's attacks in his conversation with Elon Musk, the Harris-Walz campaign said in a statement, Trump's entire campaign is in service of people like Elon Musk and himself, self-obsessed rich guys who will sell out the middle class. In Washington, Chris Pallone, NBC News.